Hidden deep in the English countryside lies the picturesque village of Guildford, home to the weird, the wonderful, and of course, to Criterion Games, and the splendid Burnout Paradise. Here, among their many trophies and awards, they fondly recall the once popular feature in their Crash TV podcast that was breaking news. Helmed by the stout, furry, and delightfully wooden figure of Doug McConkie, he gave literally his all in the quest to deliver the latest Criterion news as soon as humanly possible to our beloved viewers. But now, as we race bravely into a new era, maybe we can one day look forward to the next leap in Burnout communication technology, or at least a replacement for Doug.
This is Crash TV.
It's Crash TV 28. This week we're talking about the Criterion Games Network. And for once, I'm not joined by my usual Crash TV presenters. I'm here on my own, and that's because we're going out into the studio to take a look at where everybody works. So let's just back up a little bit here. Out of the Crash TV studio where we are on air and into the team area. Okay, here we've got the Criterion Games kitchen. And our lovely doorway here, Criterion Games, the home of Burnout. Here's our trophy cabinet. We've got a few BAFTAs in there, some GameSpot awards, all for brilliant previous Burnout games, and a few for Black as well. Right down here, we've got the 2008 Best Driving Game from Spike TV, and I believe another Academy Award on the way. Over here, we've got some cool neon and some previous Burnout covers from the magazines. And through here, it's the team. All right, so this is the team area, and this is where you'll see us all gather together to test eight-player gameplay. Usually we're there with the usual suspects. There's eight of us testing things like Markman, but today it's empty. So there's the team, but where's the Crash TV crew? Usually we'd expect to see Sergeant Sullivan, the Webster Hoff, maybe Island Pete, but they're nowhere to be seen. Ah, finally, here we are at the home of Crash TV. It's Island Pete. And what do we have there, Pete? Was that a bit of the island?
Sorry, you can't be seeing that right now.
Oh, unbelievable. So we're not here to look at the island, we're here to look at Criterion Games Network with the Webster Hoff, who's just over here. Let's go check it out.
Crash TV Spotlight.
Hey, Matt.
Hey, Jez. Top of the morning.
Top of the morning to you. And celebrating a little St. Patrick's Day there.
Oh, yeah. I don't really go to town, but, you know, I like to sort of doff my cap at the UK and Ireland Saints days.
Superb. All right, I'm going to pull up a tyre then. And
good job.
So why don't you tell people a little bit about the network page and what it is?
Okay, so the this is the Criterion Games Network page. This is what it looks like now, but it didn't start off like that, right?
It did not.
No, so we... a bit of a history lesson. We laid the foundations for this way back last year when we launched what we called the Live Page. And that came about from our desire to want to talk directly to people playing the game. And we figured that was a really important thing to form a direct connection with the fans that are playing the game, and to keep the keep building a community and telling people what was going on and giving them news about what we were up to and how we were extending the game. The natural sort of progression of that technology was to make it a website, and so that's where it's gone to now.
So what we're seeing first of all here is this is kind of bespoke. It's not just a website.
So primarily, you know, as we said, we built this for news. So if we take a look at the news tab, what we've got here is the ability to go and have a look at news. You know, we mark which ones with an exclamation mark if they're if that's new news, that news you haven't read. But we also do some other cool stuff. So as I said at the top, this is a personalized page, so there's a degree of personalization that I can do. Obviously it's taking my PSN ID or my gamer tag or my persona name if I'm on PC. I can play around with that, so I can change my tagline. And this is another thing that's really cool. So this is, you know, this is connected directly to the game, so depending on my progress through the game, I can unlock more profile pictures, and then we will unlock further profile pictures based on other secret things which we're not talking about just yet. But it's another way for us to let people do a bit of personalization, and that really comes to the fore when we start talking about the friends tab. We can see our friends on here, and I can take a look at you, for example, and
yeah.
I can pull up your stats in exactly the same format. So here I can see, you know, Chubby Jez also has his Elite license. I can just very quickly see how you're getting on throughout the game. And then, as I said, you know, we're going to be adding to this. And one of the things that we did very recently was we added Twitter support to it. So Twitter was something that was beginning to really hook with people around the world. We started using it as another means to communicate with fans of the game. And it just made total sense to then roll it into the network page. So, you know, just literally a day or two of work, and we're able to launch Twitter support.
Exactly. Well, brilliant. Thanks very much for taking us through that, Mr. Websterhof.
And you're welcome.
We're now going to show you how we actually get a story posted from my desk. So come check it out. So here we are at the Criterion Games news desk, and we're going to show you how easy it is to post a story to the network page. So I simply click on here, go to create a story, type some text, and I know, let's tell people about the amazing St. Patrick's Day parade of cars that we did, where everybody drove green cars. So I type the text for that story, I add a couple of images showing how cool it was, and then I hit send. It's as simple as that. The story goes live and you guys get to read it.
Maggots! What are you doing on Twitter? You should be training!
Sarge Sullivan. What's he going on about? Doesn't he know it's St. Patrick's Day today?
Alright, let's check the news on the Criterion Games Network today. Hey, they're celebrating St. Patrick's Day as well. Good, good, good. Right, what's going on Twitter? That's right, Prof. Today is a day all about celebration, and I know a lot about that.
Sounds like it's all crazy back in the office. Wow. I'm glad I'm out here away from it all. Oh, it's nice not being so violent.
Criterion Control, this is Jez in low Earth orbit. The Twitter test is working nicely. Getting the feed that is out of this world. And that's it for Crash TV this week. We'll see you next time. Okay, guys, I'm ready to come down now. Guys.
Mailbag@CriterionGames.com. Mail us at Criterion Games, Onslow House, Onslow Street, Guildford, Surrey, GU1, 4TN, in the UK.
Guys, is anyone there? Hello!